kind of dark object.
Somebody new. What you guys put down is interesting. Tucker, you asked a question earlier about what the race was of the individual who wrote the article, or was that Jordan?
I asked that.
Okay, Tucker, why did you ask that?
That's wondering if he was being biased.
Why?
Because it actually seems to me that he's saying to be biased.
What if he's white? That would make him not biased?
No, yeah. Biased. We need like an Asian word.
Why?
Native American.
Go ahead. Explain that.
Because they're like either and they're smart people.
So if you are outside the race of white or black, you'd be less biased?
Yeah.
How many of you agree with that statement?
I feel as though
you being white while writing this would not make you biased.
Why?
Yeah.
Because he's basically saying that white people are not treating black people as fairly. And he's being biased, he'd be saying that blacks are being treated just as equally as white people are, but instead he's saying that we aren't treating them.
But he can be biased according to black people.
Gentlemen, listen to this conversation.
What if, like, he's white, but he's like part black, part white, he's in the next year or something, and he's being biased towards black?
He said that one lady, like, oh, I'm going to be black.
Go ahead, Elaine. Say again. What if the author's female? What does it matter? So what you're telling me is that you really have to take into consideration the author of the work?
Yes.
To what degree and to what percentage?
I said we should set up a meeting.
But okay. Which is fine, but I mean that's a legitimate question at this point. So at what degree do you take into consideration the person who wrote it? The race, the gender, the economic status, the
race, gender,
geography, those kinds of things. To what degree?
Race, gender, and
right, but how and how much?
Because they don't live in that area where this is going down.
And your opinion? I like what Joe's saying. Joe just said that I can't write about what happens in Compton, California. I can't. I don't have a clue. I've read stuff about it. I've got my opinions about those kinds of things. But would my viewpoint have as much credibility as somebody who grew up there?
No.
And Delaney, what are you saying? So when you're having an opinion, it shouldn't matter? Geography, race, that kind of stuff, or it should? It should, to what degree? correct, but your opinion's being read. Your opinion has validity. My question to you is to how much validity should we give all those things that make your opinion biased? Credibility. It's, I'm gonna, you know, if I tell Jordan that my car's making a knock, I'm gonna trust what he says more than what November says. His opinion probably has a little more validity because of his experience, his background, his credibility behind it, right?
I would trust me more.
Yeah. So, Delaney, how much? How much?
I don't know.
It's an opinion again.
Why?
How much you want to take it from it.
Okay, so.
What you think is right.
Alright, so what if you were to read something about armor from somebody who lives in Corsica?
You know what?
No,
you
know that's not here.
So geography doesn't really matter a whole lot then, right?
Yeah.
On what?
Like where you grew up, I guess. It's like me personally. But if somebody from East High and Northville and Sioux City said somebody from my school, I think that would be matters.
Do you understand what he's saying? What's his best selling point? Her best selling point? I don't know. Wrote it, to be honest with you.
It.
Huh? There you go. Yes, it did not. So what's his or hers best selling point to defend the argument that you have written down on your sheet of paper? And if you want to, you can go back to your own seats and look at your screen. That's the next thing I want you to write down, though. What is the best selling point? What's the best evidence to support the argument that you wrote down? What's the best evidence?
White people.
No, write it down. What's the best evidence?
I'm giving you two.
What is the best evidence? You're okay, it's not really lead anymore. Well, and that's exactly, I got into an argument over whether maybe Wood was cuter than somebody else, and I got mad and I started stabbing my pencil on the desk, and I missed the desk and got my
head. Nice job, Shunder.
First grade.
That's
first grade romance.
I got lead.
Mrs.
Snyder,
what is the best evidence to support the argument that you wrote down?
Graphics.
I like that. Good, good, good. What is the best evidence?
Hey, is that a water
game? Next Tuesday is a matter. It wouldn't be my day. So
we were supposed to be Mr. Butter. We've been missing a lot of classes.
You have the Career and Fair Expo in Mitchell.
Yeah,
it's
a lot
of
folks on Saturday. We're not going on Friday because of marketing. I'm so excited
to get out of class.
I'm not too excited about marketing.
Go ahead. What is the best evidence?
Best evidence of what?
To support the argument that you wrote down.
Are you not going to be here?
supposed to rain black.
Seriously?
Hit the little red button on that iPad, though.